Hey guys, first off, I'd like to say thank you for tuning in to my channel today. I don't normally do this, and it's not really a review, it's just something I want to talk about. It's a product that I got from an individual. I asked for it specifically, and I would like to talk about it. I told him I would, good or bad, and luckily I've had a good experience with it, and I would like to share it with you. So first off, there is a drone, a little tiny drone called an Inductrix that Horizon Hobby makes. And there's been a few people, especially a guy named Jesse Perkins that you guys probably know of. He's trademarked the term Tiny Whoop. And it's essentially an Inductrix drone, which is this little tiny drone about something that fits in the palm of your hand. And he ended up sticking a camera on it, and you can fly it around first person view. And it's been a really cool thing for people getting into the hobby because it's very inexpensive. And it's also something that's very hard to break because of how small it is. You can fly it indoors, you can fly it around your kids, you can crash it into stuff, and it just doesn't do anything to whatever you crash it into because it's so light and so small. And also the propellers are protected by these ducted fans, which is really just a protective little cover that goes on the outside of it and helps with the name Inductrix. So let's talk about what I got from this company. So the company is NewBEEDrone.com, and there's a guy named Ryan Fay over there. And really, I found out about this company a few months ago. Well, not necessarily, a little longer ago than that. It was probably about 6 months ago, and I needed some FR Sky X4Rs, and there were none in stock. It was kind of like a drought where X4Rs were hard to find, and this guy messaged me and said, "Hey, I have some of these. Can you order them from my site just to let me know if my site's working?" Because he was like brand new. I ordered from his site, and that's kind of how I got introduced to these guys. They've always been really nice to me, and then they ended up sponsoring one of my good friends, Jameson Malpezzi, that I met in Las Vegas. He ended up getting our luggage from the airport when Chad and I missed our flight. So anyways, long story short, NewBEEDrone, it's always been this company that I've known about, and I never really ordered much from them, but you know, they've got some cool products that I feel like need to be mentioned. Now, there's something in this box right here. This box has one of the coolest things out there, I think, that you can buy right now as far as a tiny whoop or a small drone goes. Now, first off, I'll just go ahead and say thank you, Ryan, for sending me this, because it is one of the coolest things that I have gotten as far as something in this small of a package. So this is it. It's a Beeductrix, and it comes from NewBEEDrone.com. And yeah, it's special. Now I'll tell you why it's special here in a second. So let's go ahead and open the box. I'll show you what comes inside. Now this was pre-made for me. I ended up changing the mount that the camera mounts on because it was PLA or something like that, and it ended up breaking. So I recommend the TPU mounts personally, but I'll show you that. So this box, really sturdy, it's not gonna break. You don't have to worry about it crumbling apart when you're traveling or something. I pretty much just stuffed it in my bag and throwing stuff on top of it, and it doesn't break. Now, this is what's in the box. Now, if you can see, there is a tiny whoop. Nothing unsuspecting about that tiny whoop, except for the fact that you can see that the board underneath, which is normally the flight controller, is yellow instead of that typical green color that you see on the Inductrix. Now, the Inductrix obviously has the same frame, same propellers and everything, but you'll also notice that there is a linear polarized antenna on the top of this camera instead of a circular polarized antenna, which is what most people are running these days. And I can tell you from experience that the linear polarized antenna is way more durable than that circular polarized antenna, and it also weighs less as well. The CP antennas that are on top of most of these little 25 milliwatt cameras just freaking break. You crash on them and they're done, and you don't really need something with a circular polarized antenna for what you're going to be doing with this thing. So let's go ahead and take it out. They ended up sending me some of their batteries, which are the 205 nitro nectars. Really nice battery. It's got some decent heft to it, like most of the larger milliamp packs do. These are 205 milliamp, like I said before. They're rated from 30 to 60 C, which honestly I have no idea what that means, because C rating on a 1S battery this small is probably not accurate. But you know, they hold up to what these little motors can dish out, so I'm not complaining. So let's go ahead and pull this out of here, and we'll set the box aside. And this is it. So it's basically an Inductrix like you've seen so many times before, except it's got a different board on it. Now, if you look on the bottom, let me pull this battery off so you can see, there is a USB port right here. Now you can plug that into Betaflight. So this is called the BEEDrone, and it's an Inductrix board that's FR Sky native. They also sell it in Spectrum native, so you can bind directly to FR Sky or bind directly to Spectrum, and it runs Betaflight. Now, what that means is you can actually tune this thing, and it flies like a mini quad, which is kind of crazy. You can run air mode, you can run everything that you can on Betaflight, and it's just obnoxiously fun to fly. It's very fast too. That's why I've kind of opted for the extra camera tilt here. Now, I will say that their Stinger cam, which is what's on top here, is pretty awesome. I don't know if it's any different than most of the cameras that are out there, aside from the linear polarized antenna that's on the top. But you know, that thing has saved this little camera many times when I crash or something. It falls directly upside down on the antenna. It does not break, and the reception is just as good, if not better, than the CP antennas that I've used before. The only thing I'd say change is I changed the mount for the camera to a TPU mount. It might be a little heavier, but it's a little more flexible, and it's definitely the thing to run on these, because you are going to crash them, because you're going to be like, oh, look at that little hole, I'm going to punch through it, and then you end up not punching through it and crashing. So the motors that are on it are their motors. I don't know the specs on them. They're the fastest motors that they had, and they're really powerful. I'm sure there's someone out there that's claiming that they have higher kV or more power, but you know, for this kind of stuff, you don't really need all that crazy stuff. And these batteries, they can't really handle it. I've had some 150 batteries. Like, you put a 150 milliamp battery on here, it will puff it. I've never seen a 1S battery puff before. But yeah, after about 30 seconds of flight on a 150 milliamp, Venom pack, it came down puffy and hot, which is kind of scary. We're getting so powerful with these little things that it's puffing the batteries that are intended to fly with them. So anyways, this is an FR Sky native one. I've bound it directly to my Tyrannus, and no module required, just binds right up to Peter the Penetrator, and I can fly as far as I want with it and have no range issues at all. So let me show you guys what I've done. I'll plug it into the computer here, and I'll show you my PIDs, because I know a lot of people are like, oh, what'd you tune your tiny whoop to or whatever, and we'll figure that out right now. So anyways, there's a USB port mounted perpendicular to the board on the bottom. So yeah, you plug it in like this, and let's plug this baby in. You see the little LEDs on the top flashing, and let me grab the camera and we'll bring it over here, and I'll show you what we're working with. All right, so we've established that this thing is running Betaflight. So let's go ahead and see if we can connect. All right, we've connected. So we are connected to a tiny whoop at Betaflight, which is crazy. I never thought I would see that. But so let's go ahead and check out what we have here. Nothing special. I will say the only downside to this thing is it runs PPM instead of SBUS. Not like you're going to be able to tell that much flying something so small, but you know, if it were SBUS, I'd say that's probably the only upgrade that you could do to make this thing any better. Yeah, I have my min throttle set at 1050. Yeah, it is PPM. Even on the Spectrum, guys, it is PPM as well. Don't think that if you go to Spectrum, you're going to get that 11 milliseconds latency crap. On this particular board, it's still PPM, so don't freak out. Just go ahead and get it. It's cool. It's not gonna affect you too much. Now here are PIDs. Now most people are going to freak and say, what, those are so high, like how do you get that so high? So yeah, PIDs right there. We got 80 on the pitch, or sorry, on roll P. We got 100 on pitch P, and we got 180 on yaw P, 37 on integral, all the way in pitch and roll, and we got 45 on yaw, and then derivatives 35 35, and yeah, no yaw jump prevention. This thing doesn't have enough power to prevent or to start yaw jump. And the one thing that I will say for this thing in particular is the rates. It comes with some obnoxious rates on there. Yeah, it flips really fast, but it doesn't really perform well because it's so doughy, and then all of a sudden it's like super fast roll rates. So I tune the rates, and I'd say that's probably, like in the other videos that I've mentioned, the rate is really the best thing you can tune. PIDs are not necessarily that important anymore these days. It is important over time to get something that's
a little bit designated for your particular aircraft, but the rates are really what you want to tune. So yeah, there are the rates, RC rates 1.0 for roll, pitch, and yaw, and then super rate, whatever the heck that means, is 0.8, 0.8, 0.8, and as you can see, the max velocity in degrees is 1029, and RC Expo is, as you can see, 0.15. And yeah, I mean, other than that, nothing special. It's got RC Expo. I have no idea why it's doing that, but don't worry, it still works. Super Expo is on. And then the receiver, as you can see, just chilling. Modes, I do have air mode and angle mode if you need it. And obviously arm. So regardless, let's see how it flies. I'm gonna throw it up in the air and we're gonna fly it. And you guys can see for yourselves that it flies very well. So thank you guys for watching. If you liked what you saw, please like, subscribe, and comment below. If you wanna see me do anything special with this, you can put it in the comments below, but you know, this video is probably gonna have all the special flips and rolls and crazy stuff that you guys wanna see. So thank you very much. I hope you guys have a great day. Bye. Thank you.